Hello guys, welcome back once again to the channel Get It Quickly. As a part of the ongoing series on Notepad++, a free text editor, today we are gonna talk about a very interesting topic, which is bookmarking in Notepad++. So let's get started. This is where we left in the previous video. The first thing I'm gonna do again is clear all of that, and then I'm gonna close this guy. Right, so for this video, basically I kind of stole a Verilog code because we are gonna do some bookmarking, right? So I'm gonna open that Verilog code through Q-Dir, which is my favorite tool. If you don't know how to use it, you can watch my video, right? So there is a verilog.v file in our project one directory, so I'm gonna open this guy here, and you can see like this guy, it does have a lot of lines of codes which I kind of stole from some random website, right? So here what we are gonna do, so if you have ever noticed, like we do have line numbers in Notepad++, 1, 2, 3 and so on, and there is like a free space after the line number, and this is what I'm talking about, right? So if you ever click on any of the space here, you will notice there will be a blue ball, and that is what is called a bookmark in Notepad++. So the thing is, how do we use it and how we can increase our productivity by using bookmarks in Notepad++? Now let's take a practical example. First, toggle this guy back, and then we are gonna go scroll down a little bit and let's take this guy enable, right, at line number 72. For instance, I am interested to do something here, so let's make a comment like I will be doing something here later, right? And then what I'm gonna do is basically I scroll down and then I started working on something else on some other line. For example, here I will make another comment like, okay, I will be inserting some more lines of code later, right? And then I will start doing something. And then, for instance, I am done here, and then I have to go back where I was actually working on, and then, oh, where I was actually working. I even don't recognize the line without having a bookmark. And what if I would have done the bookmarking before? This time, I didn't face any difficulty to find that particular line, right? So that's the purpose of having a bookmark. For example, if I do a bookmark here and then I will start looking for something else and then I came back here, this is literally very recognizable and we can identify that line really quick. So it was an example, like I was going to do something else, but you can definitely bookmark any of the line of interest and then you can just come back. So for example, if we do have multiple lines of interest, like okay, wherever the enable, like this is another enable and I'm also interested in that line, so I mark this one as well. And when I say mark, you just toggle this line. For example, if I want to remove this guy, I can just click again here on the blue ball and it's just gonna toggle it, right? I mean, it's just gonna go away. So I will mark this guy as well, and then I am also interested in that enable which kind of happened here, so I kind of bookmark this guy as well, right? So now I'm gonna go back. So instead of, you know, scrolling up and find wherever I have the bookmarks, I can also use the shortcut in my keyboard, that just F2, and then it's gonna go bring me to the next bookmark. And if I just do one more time, you can see like the scrolling thing, it will go it directly by itself. So just press F2 again and then it brings me here, and I can try it like a couple of times. Right now I just have like 3 bookmarks, and you can do it in a reverse order, like shift F2 and it's gonna go back to the previous bookmark, right? So this is one thing that we can do. Now we have several other options, like when we have bookmarks, we can do other stuff as well. So in the search tab, we do have these options in bookmark menu. Like this is the shortcut to toggle bookmark. So you can, you know, in any of the line, if you just press Control F, it's gonna bookmark, or you can just use your mouse to toggle the bookmark on any line. This is basically what I just explained. Next bookmark and previous bookmark. You can also clear all the bookmarks in one single click from here. Like if you have thousands of bookmarks, for example, and you just want to clear in one click, you can come here in the search menu and in the bookmark, and there we have an option to clear all the bookmarks altogether, right? And another option we have is like we can cut all the lines that are marked and we can paste them somewhere, or we can also copy. For example, I'm going to take an example of copy. Like I just copy all bookmarked lines, and then in the next tab and then Control V, and you can see like these are the lines that we bookmarked actually, right? So this is another option. And what other features we have, they are like remove bookmark lines, you can remove unmarked lines, or you can inverse bookmark. Let's try this guy. See, it actually inverted all of the bookmarks. So wherever we had the bookmark, now we don't have it. And where we didn't have the bookmarks, now we have them, right? So let's clear them off in just one click and all of them will be gone, right? So the last thing I'm gonna talk about is basically the mark tab in our find window. So let's explore that option as well. So to open up that window, I'm going to double click here on this enable, and then I'm going to hit Control F. You can also hit Control M to directly open the mark tab here, right? So if I'm going to go here in this tab, you can see like we do have two more options as compared to our find or replace window, right? So let's explore the options we have here in the mark tab, right? So in this situation, we are more interested to mark each and every line that has the word enable, right? But this mark tab, when we use it to do that functionality, it also highlights all of the instances. If I'm gonna check this bookmark line, which is basically gonna mark all of the lines that have the word enable. But when I click mark all of the instances of enable, they will be highlighted as well. Let's try this guy. See, it actually marked all of the lines that we have here that contain enable, but it also highlighted the word enable, right? If I click here, then you can see like we actually have all the enables highlighted with red. So in some cases, of course, it's very good thing because this also highlighted the word enable. So it is more recognizable. You can identify wherever you have the word enable and in which line it does exist. Okay, so let's try deleting this highlighting, right? So come back here in the mark tab and uncheck the bookmark line option, because if I'm gonna clear all bookmarks, it will clear all the bookmarks as well as the highlighting. I just want to clear the highlighting, but I want to keep the bookmarks as well. So I uncheck this guy and then I clear all marks. And this way you can have all the bookmarks, but you can just, you know, remove the highlighting if you want to, right? Now let's talk about the last option we have here, which is purge for each search. So let's do it before we actually understand what it does, right? So I'm gonna select this guy encoder in, and then I'm gonna go in the mark tab, and then I'm gonna select bookmark line, and then I'm gonna select purge for each search, and then I'm gonna mark all. See what happened? Basically, it removed all the bookmarks from the enable, and then it bookmarked the encoder ones, and that's what the purge for each search. But what if I want to keep the enable ones as well? So I can uncheck this guy and select enable back and then bookmark as well. And now you have all the bookmarks with enable and encoder in, And if you wanna delete the highlighting, you can just uncheck this guy and then clear all marks. And in that case, you have all the bookmarks and you don't have the highlighting. We will discuss the highlighting thing. This is very cool feature actually, but in a separate video. Okay, so that's it for this video. I will see you in the next video. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do so that we can learn together and continue this journey all together. Thanks for watching.